What is up, y'all? Silly Dog PL here, and y'all have been asking in the comments for me to do a video on how to spank tryhard ganks. So I am here today to show you exactly how to spank those tryhard ganks. I got my trusty Iron Round Shield, got my trusty Dark Lothric Knight Sword. Anyway, let's get into it, guys. Today I'm going to show you how to spank them ganks. All the tryhards will fear you after I show you my one trick method. So step one is you're going to go into your storage box and you're going to put all the weapons that aren't a Dark Lothric Knight Sword or Chaos Dagger into the storage box. Some people might want to assess this for parrying, but you know what? Let's be real. Regen is not necessary. None of that is necessary. All you need is a Lothric Sword and a Chaos Dagger. Get rid of crossbows. Talisman, we'll use it for tiers, so that's alright. Iron Round Shield, every other shield should go in the storage box. If you're not wearing the Thrall Hood, I don't want to know you. And throw all the fashion that isn't your, you know, normal set in there too. We'll keep rings, but the most important one is the Hornet Ring. That's going to let us win. That is the one quick trick to win every single gank. We're switching tiers from Fire Surge so that we can survive if, you know, we ever do get hit, which is probably unlikely if we're honest. Anyway, come with me on a journey. A journey to Gank City. Welcome to Gank City, y'all, home of only the most ruthless, most tryhard ganks. Literally every host here has a million billion hours just ganking. They have the utmost ganking experience, and those are the only people who host here. So, I mean, if you kill one of them, it counts as killing one of the most tryhard ganks in the entire world. Anyway, let's get into it. Let's invade. So what you're gonna want to do when you spawn in for the first time is gonna cast tears, because, you know, it is an invasion. There's a chance you might take a hit. You're facing tryhard, really good players. You know, just in case you take a hit or two here, and somehow, some way, despite my amazing method, they manage to reduce your health to zero. You know, you're gonna want those tears just in case, so that you can get back up and then pwn them. Okay, so there was, you see there? I went for a parry. And you're going to want to do that at every single opportunity possible. The Iron Round Shield is actually regarded as broken by a whole bunch of tournament level duelists because of how powerful it is. See, I went for a backstab there. Nope, that's not going to do. I took damage because I went for a backstab, so instead we're going to just keep on going for parries. This guy hasn't taken the bait yet, but you know he will soon. Maybe just run up in his face and hit L2. Oh shit, it worked. See? Instant win. 1,384 Chaos Dagger riposte. Works literally every time, guys. Silly Dog PL guaranteed that will work 100% of the time. Look at how mad his overleveled boyfriend is. See, he was a tryhard ass ganker. Unbelievable. Ugh. Man, recording that intro or finding footage for that intro just made me feel dirty. Wearing the Thrall Hood makes me feel kind of unclean inside. In this invasion, my co-invader is an invader who I respect and, like, is really good. And I felt so ashamed of being seen with the Thrall Hood on that I actually took it off and went bareheaded. Absorption values be damned. Anyway, we do get a Fighter PL trademarked Hornet Ring Chaos Dagger post here. Hashtag trolled, y'all. Hashtag trolled. But anyway, I have gotten several requests for a video on how to spank tryhard ganks. Whether it's, you know, a bunch of laps in the woods at soul level 30, or a bunch of password summoned phantoms, you know, post pontiff level 125. People are asking me a few times, just a few times, for a video on how to beat tryhard ganks. And additionally, I have seen other YouTubers. I think I saw Chase the Bro and Biter PL at one point. They put out a video at some point, I don't remember exactly when, with the title "How to Gank Spank" or "How to Beat Tryhard Ganks" or something along those lines. And I suppose this video is not a video on how to spank tryhard ganks. Largely because I feel like putting out a video like that would be disingenuous to my viewers. No hate for Chase or Fighter. I think they've both worked very hard to get where they are. Put out a shit ton of content. However, if I'm honest, I don't feel entirely comfortable putting out a video titled How to Spank Ganks. Like there's a tried and true formula to the thing. Like there's a one trick that will work every time. It's just not that simple when it comes down to it. So I don't feel like I can make a video titled that, or a video exactly on that topic. So why is that? Well, before I say exactly why, let's cover a topic quickly that I'm sure we are all very familiar with, and that I'm honestly tired of talking about. Host advantages in DS3, I'm exhausted of listing out all the advantages that the home team has in DS3, but you know what, for fun, we'll do it one more time. Being on the home team in DS3 gets you twice the Estus, Embered HP, the ability to summon up to 3 Phantoms against 2 Invaders, the ability to summon any player on any level character, the ability to instantly resummon password Phantoms, the ability to be on mic with your teammate, the ability to auto-summon via Way of Blue, no friendly fire with any of your teammates, the ability to turn the Invaders' only support against them for 45 seconds via the Seed of the Giant Tree, and additionally, Invaders tend to have an upward invasion range, so chances are the host is higher level than the Invader is too. Anyway, we've hit the breakdown. These are some really significant advantages. So, here's the question of the day. What can you do to beat a tryhard gank of 3 or 4 solid PvPers utilizing all of these advantages to the fullest? You all ready for the secret? The truth of what you can do against 3 or 4 solid PvPers utilizing home team advantages? Here's the answer. You can't do anything. You're fucked. Okay, that was probably overdramatic and not entirely accurate. There are definitely things you can do to increase your odds of winning against a gank of 3 or 4 tryhard players, and it's not like ganks of 3 or 4 tryhard players are literally unkillable. Sometimes some of them will die. It's incredibly rare. If you manage to spank a gank like that, count yourself lucky, I would say. Chances are it happened through a combination of very good plays on your part and some major mistakes on their part. Let's start with that. How does a gank of 3 or 4 good, solid PvPers die in DS3? The answer is making gigantic fucking mistakes. Regardless of how good a host normally is at PvP, if they make a big enough mistake that it costs them 2,000 HP in a very short amount of time, chances are that they are going to die from it because, you know, 2,000 HP is their entire health bar. If you can kill them before they can reach their flask because they make a giant mistake like that, then you're sitting pretty. You've won the invasion against a tryhard gank of 3. Anyway, but for the most part, they're going to have to make a major mistake for you to win against 3 good players. The fact is that the advantages are just too strong in their favor otherwise. So here's the second question. If it's so difficult to kill a gank full of 3 good players, 3 solid PvPers, how do I have a YouTube channel? How do I put out content every week where, you know, I kill people who look like they know what's up with the game, they're using a dark infused plow, they can't be too bad? The answer is that even though their equipment has changed, many of these gankers are still pretty average when it comes to PvP. Back in, you know, 2016 or whatever, invaders could beat ganks of 3 or 4 people because, you know, they had unfinished builds and they fell to things like third hit straight sword R1 spam parries. Gankers don't really do that anymore, but the fact is that they're still ganking. They're not really testing themselves. They're not getting better. Just because they know something about PvP now, it doesn't make them actually that good at the game. Almost all of the gankers that I encounter, I would say, are worse than I am in terms of a 1v1 individual basis. they haven't been put in as tough of situations as I have. I have to outplay four people. They have to outplay one and a turtle cleric with three dudes backing them up. The fact is that, you know, even if they know something about PvP, like how to not get backstabbed, you can still outplay them to a certain degree, that beating these ganks is entirely possible, especially if you have the right co-invader. Frankly, some ganks nowadays, it is entirely necessary to have the right co-invader because they are PvP savvy enough and have strong enough builds that they are basically impossible to kill otherwise, healing miracle ganks especially. But anyway, just because they have dark infused plows and dark infused straight swords doesn't make them good at PvP. Gear is not the same thing as talent, or skill, experience, whatever you want to call it. And the first step to beating a tryhard gank, or something that looks like a tryhard gank, is telling yourself that they're not actually that good. If you're not even believing in your ability to beat one of them in a 1v1, there is not a chance that you can beat them in a 1v4. But considering the title of this video, I feel it would be improper to let you all off without giving you some actual, generalized, overall tips on how to beat ganks. So, here we go. Probably all of you know all of these already, but, here we go. Silly Dogs, 5 tips to spank the gank. Tip number 1. Be opportunistic. On a practical level, your chances of outplaying a gank to such a degree that all of them run out of Estus, especially considering how easy it is to resummon, your chances of outplaying them to that degree are low. Therefore, phantoms have to die before they can reach their flask. Burst damage is very important as an invader if you're looking to win against really good ganks. Not as important as Ouroboros thought it was, but still very important. If you have an opportunity to finish a phantom off, take it. Take it with all you've got. Tip number 2, kind of at odds with the first one. Prioritize survival. If there is not a good, obvious opening to finish a phantom off, just surviving and not replenishing the gank's Estus is a huge help to your fellow co-invaders and greatly increases your chance of winning the invasion. Tip number 3, control what you can. There's a whole lot of shit that you cannot control in DS3 invasions. You can't control the gankers' builds, you can't control the number of gankers, you can't control your co-invaders' builds, you can't control summon lag, regular lag, how dumb the RK Pug's hitbox is. But for everything that you can't control in this game, there are a whole bunch of things that you can control. Your absorption values, your poise values, the weapons that you have at your disposal, the tiers, or the spells that you have at your disposal. All these things you can control. And taking control of what you can is a great route to winning more invasions in DS3. I forgot tip number 4, so we're going to skip straight over to tip number 5. Tip number 5 is to have fun with it all. In the grand scheme of things, DS3 invasions don't mean a whole lot. Whether you kill ganker XX_DarkSoul_XX doesn't really matter, and at the end of the day, you'll probably have forgotten it in a week. But one thing I can say for sure is that regardless of whether you end up with a Pale Tongue or not, if you didn't have fun, you lost the invasion.